Hi, I'm Senate Majority Leader Mike Shirkey, and I'd like to share a message for everyone in Michigan from the Michigan Senate Republicans. 3 weeks ago, Governor Whitmer acted quickly to apply broad restrictions to our daily lives. These measures were taken to protect the health and safety of all Michiganders and help support our frontline healthcare workers battling the effects of COVID-19. For the past few weeks, the Senate Republicans have been working on ways to support workers and families since our governor issued her stay home, stay safe order. We've identified opportunities for common sense revisions of that order and have shared our suggested improvements with the governor's team. Successfully mitigating the impact of this virus will take a team effort from every Michigan resident. It is essential that we abide by the health and safety recommendations that are in place now. To be truly successful in recovering from this virus, it will also require us to look ahead. We must start planning today on how we can best position Michigan for a healthy recovery. This means we need to start looking at how our state will be able to move forward and get people back to their jobs, their livelihoods, to support their families in a safe and healthy manner. For many people, work is a key component of mental health. Without the option to maintain employment, many of our citizens will experience extreme mental stress, and that in turn can manifest as physical ailments, a weakened immune system, and lead to tense domestic environments. The more prepared we are to bring workplaces back online, the quicker we can reduce the stress levels we are all feeling. Developing a plan to get people back to work, to provide for their family, relieve the stress of wondering how they repay their bills, and how they can do so safely is paramount to a successful and healthy recovery. We all remain very concerned about the health and well-being of the legions of our frontline workers and their families, and we will not compromise their safety in any way and will continue to support their amazing and inspiring work. But we'll also do the necessary work to be prepared to emerge from the peak of this pandemic into a transition period. That transition period is anchored upon safe behavior for safe workplaces. Today, the Senate Republicans will begin the process of developing a plan to transition to a safe behavior for safe workplaces mindset and operating principles. Our process will begin with the formation of a Senate bipartisan work group consisting of Senators Horn, Schmidt, VanderWaal, Chang, Santana, and Moss. And Senator Horn will lead this effort. These senators will work feverishly and determinedly to aggregate information from multinational businesses who have proven their protocols and disciplines have worked to protect their employees. They will actively pursue expert input from medical professionals, and most importantly, this group will do the extra work to reach out to citizens across Michigan. Their singular objective, to create actionable recommendations leading us toward safe behavior for safe workplace policies so Michigan can prepare and accelerate out of our transition back to work. There are many industries and businesses across Michigan that already lend themselves to disciplined social distancing and require few, if any, modifications to meet strict health and safety guidelines to remain open and operational and safe. Michigan's stay home, stay safe order is more strict and rigid than many other states whose experience data regarding COVID-19 is every bit as good or better than the results we are achieving here. Senate Republicans will begin to direct our attention to these business and commercial operations who can, with predictable and proven success, ensure their workplaces are approaching, if not exceeding, the safety of being home. This will be done in consultation with medical experts to ensure the safety of the employees and others. Most workplaces, if we properly challenge ourselves, can be as safe as home. And let there be no doubt, the citizens of Michigan are anxiously awaiting for their opportunity to prove they are up for this challenge. It will require quick, disciplined adoption of proven best practices by our businesses and employees. And it will require equal discipline and commitment of all citizens to meet this challenge. Reasonable revisions to the order can help bring sectors of our economy back online soon and safely. For the long term, our willingness to embrace medically advised behaviors like fastidious hygiene, social distancing, and the use of masks is the key to transitioning back to a more typical daily life. We are calling on all Michiganders to embrace recommended health and safety behaviors. We can show the world that we can be ready to thrive as risk decreases and our economy comes back online. Some businesses will be able to adopt and transition quickly. those whose business models include large congregations of people and difficult to limit interactions with the public will take longer to meet safe behavior for safe workplace standards. Safe behaviors requires all citizens and employees to manifest the most fundamental of American principles when our country is under attack, subordinating me to we. Safe workplaces will challenge all businesses to reevaluate their routine practices and policies in order to protect their employees, their customers, their families, their neighbors, and their business. These two elements, safe behaviors and safe workplaces, are of equal importance. The success of each is dependent upon the other. We all have to be all in. There is a pathway to impacting the speed of our recovery. We cannot wait nor attempt to achieve a no-risk environment. The only guaranteed outcome of seeking to achieve no risk is no freedoms and no liberties. And that is not an America any of us desire or would recognize. Our goal is to have actionable recommendations to the governor by April 17th. It is a very aggressive goal. It will require enormous effort. Our fellow citizens in Michigan deserve nothing less. So here is our call to action. Continue to follow the health and safety behaviors in place today and start mentally and physically preparing to embrace the necessary behavior and work environment changes as we lock arms together, figuratively, to get Michigan back to work safely. And may God continue to bless you and everyone and everything you touch.